All right. So, I think I found out what was going wrong. So, if I rerun this test, and we'll let the test rerun, see what the emulator says. All right. So, test students. Well, here's the problem. What I didn't test is this. I didn't test that. So we're going to try this one out. So we're going to try it again. Now, the reason why this is important is because this is equals student compare student. But, student test. Oh, no, that one still worked. That's a little bit weird. Object. Okay. Let's try this. Oh, wait, I got a good idea. We'll do A is equal to object of B. All right, so let's rerun this. So basically, A and B, according to our .equals method, are supposed to be the same. When we run this again, it'll come out differently because a different kinds of equals method will be run. In particular, it'll be object equals. And we see here, it fails. The reason why object equals is being called is because we're throwing an object in. So if we go to the definition here of R equals, we can see that it is a student, but we're supposed to override the object. Okay, so the thing coming in, what we should do is we should first check to see if it is a student. Okay, so we'll go compare student get class equal this dot get class. We can also go if compare student equal null, we're going to return false because an object can't be equal to null if you're calling equals on it, which means the object already exists. Now, I've got this thing here where if they're the same, where if they're the same class, then we can call this dot equals student, because we know it's a student. I can go compare student, and we can see which equals it refers to. It'll go to the student dot equals. Oh, I gotta put a semicolon on there. All right, so let's rerun our test again. We'll rerun them, and so I think what my error was is that I didn't fulfill the interface properly. No, that's still bonkers. Add student to string. So this one's still complaining because our student doesn't, it's not a public boolean. So it overrides equals an object. So the other one doesn't override. So this one does. So what we're doing here is we're saying call this student.equals, and if they're the same, you return it. Otherwise, you return. Oh, I'm silly. Here's my error. I want to return this expression. This wouldn't have been a problem if I didn't like an else here, right? Okay, so there's my bug. Let's redo this. All my tests now pass. Why? Because I was being silly. I'll just negate this this check, and I'll move this down. We'll save that. We'll rerun it. And it passes. So, student manager test finally passes. All these silly little tests pass. The serialization passes in and out. So, we at least know that works. So what we can do now is we can make a singleton. Or we can get access to student list manager in our student list controller. So let's see here. Do we call get student list in here? Get student list. Yes, we do call it in here. All right. What did I do? It says something broke. Multiple markers in this line. Get cannot be resolved to a type. Get student list. Okay. Save it. It all works. But we want the student list to come from a student list manager. And so what we can do is we can make like a kind of singleton version of the student list manager. So we can go public get manager, public static student list manager, and we can make ourselves a private static student list manager and start off as null. Context, get the manager there, and then we can go if student list manager equal to null, then we're going to get the manager with the, we're going to create a student list manager with that context, and we're just going to assign it to that. Then we'll return the student list manager. Right? So now we've got the singleton. We only really need the context once. It can be null other times. Doesn't always have to exist. Student list manager will produce. We'll allow us to get the student list manager. We can start it at any time. I'm just complaining about that one, so I'll just get rid of it. So we can get our student list manager at any time. We still need our student list. So what we should do is we should put an if statement here. If the context equal null, throw new runnable missing context or student list manager. No exception type, runtime exception. So the idea here is if we call this and we haven't asked it before, then we're going to have to do it. What I really want is I basically want this. I want init manager context. And then I want that to basically do this. And what I want here is if the student list manager is equal to null, I want to did not initialize manager. So now it's assumed this will work if everything's all set up. So now for the student list controller, what we can do is we can hook it into the student list manager and go student list manager get manager load student list. We can go student list equals that. Now in student list manager, if the student list doesn't exist, it'll just make a new student list. Whereas here, it'll do fine. Okay, what's it? All right, surround with try catch. Throw new runtime exception. Could not deserialize student list from student list manager. The runtime exceptions, we don't have to declare where they come from. But they require us to be aware that they could occur at any time. Could not deserialize student list. Both of these are probably the same. Okay. So let's do that. And also maybe another one of these public void save. Student list. So what we want is student list manager, get manager, save student list, and we're going to go get student list. Okay. It's complaining that this is unlikely to be thrown. All right, so we got save student list, stuff like that. Now, this stuff isn't going to work in our activities unless our activities, such as main activity on create, unless this activity actually initializes the student list manager. So student list manager, init manager, and the context we could give this, or we could go this get application context, and that will be a generic context. So I'm going to copy that line to my other activities. So my onCreate here. And my, I also had the main activity and list student activity and bulk import activity. Okay, so let's make sure our tests still pass. Okay, good. Now let's run our application. So we want to run it as an Android application. Choose a student, test student. Okay. Now let's go edit students. And let's add Abram. Student and Abram. Okay. Save and quit. Let's go to settings and get rid of it. And it's called student picker for stop. Okay, go home, start student picker. We only have test student. I'm actually a little bit worried where that's coming from. All right, so one thing we have to do is we have to save things. So probably what we should do is for the student list manager, we should add it as a, well, what we can do is we can add a listener to the student list. We can go student list add listener, new listener, and it's overriding on update. And then on update, what we can do is we can go save student list. Okay, so when we update the student list, it should automatically save. Okay, so let's try that now. So we're going to restart student picker. Test student. Activity not started. The current task has been brought to the front. Okay, let's try it again. Okay, choose a student, test student. Let's go edit students. Let's add Abram. Unfortunately, student picker has stopped. So why did it stop? Let's see. Illegal state activity at Android view. Android OS, reflect OS, native, Delvik. That's not good. Caused by Java runtime exception. Could not deserialize student controller 39. Okay, so student controller 39, that is right here. And it should have printed our stack trace for us. And our stack trace is right here. And it says, not serializable exception, student list controller $1. Okay, I think I know what this is. So $1 means that it's a anonymous class, right? So it'll basically take the file that we define it in and it will give it a new name, such as list controller. So let's go to student list controller. Let's look for an anonymous class. So this is the anonymous class. Oh, so basically what it's saying is it can't serialize this, right? Here's the question. Does it need to serialize this? The answer is no, it does not. So let's go back to our student list and let's tell the system that we do not want to, that we don't need it to save this. So I'm going to save that and then let's rerun the student picker. So go back to console. It's trying. Okay. All right. It died again. Probably because we totally wrecked it by saving bad stuff. A legal state cannot execute the activity. We couldn't do that because we had a null pointer exception at student list add listener 59. Student list 59. All right. Listeners equal null. Now, one of the problems with serializable is that we need to deal with stuff that doesn't get dealt with. So if we jump here, we'll go to serializable. When we deserialize, it'll be null. So we have to be aware that some things will be null. So we can look for listeners. So find notify listeners. So let's see, implement serialization judiciously. So what we need is we should implement this read object thing. And so what we'll do is we'll go back to our student list, which implements serializable, and we will deal with this. And what we'll do is we'll go listeners equal new array list listeners, import IO exception. All right. So this is because this comes from, should come from object itself. So basically you can take control of your serialized form by implementing these two methods. All right, so let's give this a shot. Okay, student picker threw up again. And why did it throw up this time? Null pointer exception in choose student 47. Choose student 47, student list 47. 47. Okay. Doesn't seem about right. Cannot execute activity. All right, so let's rerun our tests. Let's make sure this stuff still works. Okay, running, lots of running. Oh, here we go. Let's go to console. All right. So our test student to string is dying right there at student list size. So So it's saying student list is not being it's not being initialized. Okay. So it's saying, oh, I think we broke read object. I think what we're supposed to do is we're supposed to say super in read object. Method is undefined for type object. All right, serializable. Okay. I think what's happening is that we need to basically deserialize everything. All of our object input stream stuff. So to take control. Okay. All right, so let's forget about this one. So this one's going to be too complicated. So what we want is whenever we refer to listeners, so listeners, right? We basically need to make sure that our listeners are not null. So we can do private get listeners. We can go array list listener, get listeners, and we can go if listeners equals to null, then we're going to go listeners equal new array list listener return listeners. Okay, and then we can go we can go get listeners. Get listeners. And we can go get listeners. Okay, so then let's retry our tests. It's instrumenting, it's going, it's executing, and our test pass. So now let's go and run our program again. We'll run as Android application. Okay, so let's add a student. We'll add Abram. Abram is added. We'll return. We'll go back in the student picker. We got test student and Abram. Go back in the student picker. Let's go edit students. Let's get rid of delete that one. Let's add James. Let's return. Let's kill off that running Android app. And so it's student picker. We're going to force stop it. Okay. We're going to go home. And then we're going to go student picker. Right. So this means if I go edit, It saved my app. It works now. And I didn't have to do a ton of work, and it automatically saves every single time I manipulate that list. Why? Because it'll notify all the listeners. And the listeners won't get saved, right? Because they won't get saved to disk because I marked it as transient. All right, so that was a bunch of work. One thing we got to do right now is... Oh, we got untracked file. I want to add that file. Git add. I'll add that file. And now we see we did a bunch of work, a bunch of serialization work, a bunch of tests. Serialization and testing thereof. Learned some lessons about dot equals. So we got that. And then we'll go to student picker test. And we'll commit that. Oh, we should add a student list manager. Git add student list manager